Now, in this video, we will going to discuss about the stress strain and deformation in a stepper bar. So here, this sketch shown is a stepper bar having section 1, section 2, and section 3, having A1, A2, and A3 are the three different cross sections having length L1, L2, and L3 subjected to tensile load P acting in either in opposite direction to each other. So, once we will go to explain this, consider a structural member of stepper section subjected to an axial pull of P as shown in figure. Let L1, L2, L3 be the length of sections of 1, 2 and 3 respectively. A1, A2 and A3 be the corresponding area of cross sections. Let P is the applied axial load. Let E be the Young's modulus of the material because the material is same for all the cross sections. Though each section is subjected to the same axial load P, the stress strain and change in length will be different. So next we will see how this will going to be different. So when you take the section 1, what is the stress? When you take the section 1, what is the stress? The load acting on the cross-sectional area, applied cross-sectional area. So which is that A1. So when the stress at A1 is will be sigma 1 will be equal to load is same. So P by A1. So what is strain? Epsilon 1 will be equal to sigma 1 by E. So what is sigma? P by A1 into E. So that is equal to P by A1 into E. What is delta L1? Delta L1 is nothing but, so if you consider epsilon 1 delta L1 by L1, so if you substitute that epsilon 1 will be equal to delta L1 by L1, so that is equal to P by A1 into E. So since I want delta 1 because that is the extension, so delta 1 will be equal to P into, so here we are cross multiplying that L1 here, so P into L1 by A1 into E, since the material is same. Now when you are considering section 2 now, again the load is applied is same P. So what is stress at the cross sectional area of 2? So sigma 2 will be equal to P by A2. So what is epsilon 2? Epsilon 2 is nothing but sigma 2 by E. So sigma is what is sigma 2 is what? P by A2. Substitute the value of sigma 2 as P by A2 into E. So now you take the epsilon 2 is equal to delta L2 by L2. So what is delta L2 extension? So delta L2, that is the extension, will be equal to P into L2 by A2 into E. Similarly, if you are considering the stress at the section 3, sigma 3 will be equal to P by A3. So then epsilon 3 will be equal to sigma 3 by E. So that is equal to P by A3 into E. So therefore, delta L3 will be equal to P into L3 by A3 into E. Since we have three cross-sectional areas, we have found out the stress, the strain, and the extension. Now, what is the total change in the length of the bar? What is the total change in the length of the bar? The total change in the length of the bar will be equal to delta L, which will be equal to delta L1 plus delta L2 plus delta L3. Why all those things which will going to be the, because all the cross-sectional areas will going to have the same load which is applied. So since it is the tensile load, always it is under tension. So you will going to get the positive value. So delta 1, L1, substitute the value of delta L1, delta L2 and delta L3 in corresponding positions. So what is that? Delta L1 will be equal to P into L1 by A1 into E plus P into L2 by A2 into E plus P into L3 by A3 into E. Because we have the same same load is acting at all the different cross-sectional areas. So that is the reason why we are considering it as P. And since the material of the stepper bar is same for all the cross-sections, therefore you will going to get it as E. So by taking the common factor of P by E, therefore delta L will be equal to P by E into L1 by A1 plus L2 by A2 plus L3 by A3. Suppose if the sections are made of different materials like the composite material, then what happens? Delta L will be equal to P into L1 by A1 into E1 plus P into L2 by A2 into E2 plus P into L3 by A3 into E3. Therefore, delta L will be equal to, since the load is same for all the cross sectional areas, P will be P into taking the common factor as P, that into L1 by A1 into E1 plus L2 into A2 into E2 plus L3 into A3 into L3 by A3 into E3. So this is how you will be able to find out the change in or the total change in the length of the bar. So this is how you will be able to obtain the stress strain relations and deformation in the stepped bar. Thank you.